Hey guys, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate.
And my name is Will, and today we're gonna take you guys on a tour through the ROCKWOOD Ultralight 2304DS.
This one's really cool because it is a double slide and 25 foot, and so you fit a lot of stuff without the length into this coach.
Yeah, with two slide outs, on one on each side of the camper, it feels like a dancing hall inside, so let's get started. Now, the ROCKWOOD 2304DS is built unlike most trailers out there. You have a completely vacuum bonded product on all five sides. So your front, back, side walls, and roof are all a vacuum bonded product, which makes them very unlikely to ever have a delamination issue. Now, your subfloor on this is also marine grade treated plywood, which is very, very good at repelling water as well.
Yeah, for the weight of this coach, we have 5586. That's the dry weight of it, how it is just as is. Now after you put all your water and camping gear, it has a carrying capacity as well.
You have up to 43 gallons of fresh water capacity. Now even if you filled that up all the way, that's not gonna eat much of your cargo capacity at all. But it allows you to go for a longer period of time away from hookups. You also happen to have two 30 gallon propane tanks, which are also very good when you're going for a longer extended camping trip.
While we're talking about tanks, you also have a gray tank, mm-hmm. which is your shower and sink water, as well as a black tank, which is your toilet water. Those are both 37 gallons apiece.
Now, when you guys go camping a little bit later in the season too, it's also important to note that we've optioned all of these 2304DSs with tank heating pads that allow you to heat the tanks if the temperature drops a little bit.
Let me tell you a little bit about the front end of this coach, and then we'll kind of move off to the side. This is a fiberglass front. This is an automotive windshield grade glass up here. This is an LED light strip so that you can see what you're doing in addition to your power tongue jack here. This is really nice too, by the way, if you're going to have an equalizer hitch or a weight distribution hitch, because the easiest way to get a weight distribution hitch on and off is to hook onto the ball, mm-hmm. pull it up so that you loosen up the bars and then put it back down. And all that up and down motion is a lot easier with a power front tongue jack.
Yep.
We also have a battery disconnect on here. So what you should always do before you disconnect or before you put your camper away in storage is disconnect your battery. Now you can do that by taking the strap off the battery box, lifting the battery. Hopefully you brought your tool with you to take off the negative, and then you're good to go. The reason why you want to do that is so that you don't drain your battery with things like your propane leak detector or radio. Maybe you accidentally left a light on. An easier way to do that, because those batteries, they'll drain after about a week of being in storage, maybe two, is this little red key underneath there. You just turn that and then you don't have to worry about any power draining mm-hmm. from that battery. The other thing that I like about ROCKWOOD is they have the diamond plate. So all your mud and rocks and everything are going to hit this instead of your fiberglass.
Yep. Now speaking about batteries, it's also important to note that this camper is prepped with a solar panel hookup ready to go. So what this does is, this plug right here allows you to plug in a portable solar panel. And the nice thing about a portable is, if the sun changes position on you, or if you're in a shady spot, you can plug into this.
The sun never changes position.
Never changes position. But then if you pop it out, you can always get, you know, optimal rays charging your solar panel, which in turn feeds your batteries, and that keeps them charged as well.
And solar panels are an awesome option, especially here in Colorado when we have like 350 days of sun or something mm-hmm. crazy like that. So you get a lot of use out of it compared to other places in the country.
Yeah. Now right above your solar panel plug is your control for your front stabilizer jacks. There's also another one of these switches in the back. So you just press it like this to retract, press it like this to extend. I also like to mention this is a very simple option, but it's been a long time coming in the RV world. No longer do you have those cheap plastic clips to hold your baggage doors in place. Instead, you have this piece of metal and a magnet up there. It just holds it on its own, so you're no longer breaking all those little plastic clips. Also important to note that this has slam latches, and if you look at the thickness of this door here, that is an insulated door. Many guys do not put that on their campers.
Also, I'll point out too, this is metal instead of plastic. A lot of the competition is using plastic if they do a slam latch door, which is problematic because plastic eventually breaks.
Now, of course you saw there's a little bit of storage here, right? Now that's right back here, beyond this, is where your Murphy bed stores. But they still give you pass-through storage right here under your couch. And that's also accessible from in the inside, which is a great thing to have when you have a camper with a Murphy bed. You don't want to lose that pass-through storage.
I'll also turn on these lights real quick just to show you. So as you can see up there, there's some awning lights. I'll go ahead and turn that off. Oops. And then this is also a power awning, so you just push a button for this to go in and out. You can adjust it so that you make the water run this way or that way so that you don't have a big puddle right by your door.
Yep.
You also have your frameless automotive windows. Those are super nice because that way you don't have to worry about the little piece of rubber drying and cracking over time, and they just look a little bit nicer, and the windows open from the bottom, so they're a rain window, so you don't have to worry about stuff getting wet if you accidentally left it open.
And if you look here, you'll notice this little sign talks about something called a Wi-Fi Ranger. What that is, that's a Wi-Fi extender. So at a campsite where they have free Wi-Fi, you can have this router, this built-in router in your coach, amplify the signal that's at the campsite for you so you get a good, strong internet connection.
Right beside Will, you'll notice that we have three steps instead of two. Now that's because this has some really good ground clearance. That's because ROCKWOOD, they know that people take these off the beaten path. For some reason, not everybody knows that. So that's a great feature. This also has independent suspension. It's called a Torflex suspension system. So that you're being able to move these wheels independently. They also have an unheard of 10-year warranty on the axles. Whereas most axles may have just like a 1 year.
Okay guys, now this is obviously one of the slide outs here, the passenger side slide. And on this, there's a lot of features to talk about. So working from the top on down, right there, you have an outside speaker. You also have an orange light that attracts less bugs to your campsite, so you can flip that on at night if you want. This right here allows you to take a TV to the outside. And then down below is where you have two outlets where you can plug in a TV or whatever else you want. And also a coax, a cable outlet. So if you're at a campsite with cable that you're hooked into with your coach, you can bring that out here to the TV as well. And then this bar right here allows you to bring your outside grill that we include on this camper for you. So it just hooks directly onto this bar, and then there's a propane line
right
down below, a quick connect line. Oh, down over there.
Yeah.
That we have the hose for. You just connect it to the grill, connect it to the quick connect, and you're ready to start grilling. Now, Mae's gonna show you guys some stuff on the back.
So as you come back here, if you can fit through, a couple of things to note. One, notice how that is a solid piece of wall. If you do that to a lot of the competition, that's gonna be spongy. That's because it won't be a vacuum bonded wall. It won't have insulation. It'll just be a piece of plastic with the interior wall, and that's it. This is one of the few guys that do that to both the sidewalls and the top and the bottom. Also, ROCKWOOD has a very good roof on there. It's different than most of the competition. So the most of the competition has an EPDM roof or a rubber roof. What ROCKWOOD has is a Superflex roof. What that means to you is it's going to be 30% lighter. It's also maintenance free, so you don't have to put UV protectant on it every year like you do a rubber roof. It's also not going to leave chalk marks or black streaks down the side of your camper. It's also more resistant to abrasion. So if you're brushing up against some trees, like we have a ton of trees here in Greeley, even just going down the main roads where the trees have overgrown after about 3 months of summer, and all that is getting brushed up against your camper going 35 miles an hour, that's not good for your roof, right? This is going to be able to last through a lot of that.
Yep. Now, also real quick to point out, the bumper here, this is something we normally point out in videos, but it's just a regular bumper, right? But actually, you can store a sewer hose in here if you wanted to as well. Mm-hmm. So just one nice little feature to have. We do include a sewer hose for you that you can store in that bumper as well. And then this is your water heater. This is both gas and electric. It'll run when you're plugged into a shore power, when you have a generator running. It'll also work for you when you're out in the woods and you're not hooked up to anything. It has a recovery rate of 16.2 gallons per hour, so that's a very, very fast recovery rate. So pretty much everybody can get a hot shower and you can wash dishes and do whatever else you need to. Ah, yes, this is right here.
This is not too exciting because it's a wall behind a wall, but the reason why they have that there is just so that you don't accidentally store stuff in there, because this is not a storage area. Mm-hmm. You remove this screw and this has your water pump and water filtration system. So this has a 10,000 gallon water filtration system that filters all the water in the entire unit. That means you're not gonna have to bring as much water. That means you're gonna be able to stay lighter weight, not have to worry about contaminating your tanks and your lines.
That filter's good down to 0.9 microns if you're want to geek out on it. So
yeah.
directly above that, you'll see that little black piece below your running lights there. Now that is prep for a backup camera. So it's already wired for a Furion backup camera system. They just removed the dummy plug, put that in, pair it with a screen that comes with your camera, and you can put that in the cab of your truck and pull this sucker down the road. You can see what's going on behind you while you're driving. And also, of course, you can use it to help you back up as well. And one other thing to note real quick is if you look up at the roof here, you should be able to see that it has a curvature to it. So these guys have what's called a radius roof. So that means that the roof is curved. Obviously what that helps you do is that helps shed water off of the roof and not leave any standing pools up there. And also sometimes roofs can be really dusty. And when that happens, you can get black streaks down the side. But on the corner, on each corner of the roof, you'll see those little black pieces sticking out. Those are gutters that are designed to shoot that water away from your camper, and so you minimize all the black streaks running down.
Well, and the other thing I've seen, Will, is if they don't have those, that water will like kind of work its way back to the camper, and mm-hmm. once it catches here, I've seen a lot of campers, they'll rot on this bottom half of the corner.
Yep.
Just because enough water hits it, it's gonna happen,
there all
right?
the time, yeah.
Over here, moving on to this spot, we have an antifreeze inlet. So you have the ability to winterize your coach. So what you need to do is you need to take off, usually you have to take off the, there's an inlet and an outlet to your water pump.
Yep.
You have to take off the tube that goes to the in portion of your water pump. And then when you do that, that makes a mess all over the floor in this hard to reach area. And then you have to hook up your jug of antifreeze, suck it all the way through. Instead of having to worry about all that mess, you just hook up to this and you're good to go.
Yeah, that'll pump all the antifreeze through your whole system.
You also have a hard shell spare tire cover. That's super nice because after about 2 years, this will start to look really ratty unless you have this. So again, Rockwood's just choosing not to cut all the corners. That is why they are the number one selling fiberglass camper out there and have been for several years, actually. Yeah.
Now over on this side, there's a lot to talk about, but let's start from the bottom here. Down here is where you have your dump valves. So obviously this right here, the larger tube is your black, goes to your black tank, which is your toilet waste. The smaller tube is for your gray tank, which is your shower and sink waste. So what the one thing that Rockwood does that's really nice is if you look under here, you see this plastic barrier, and you see that they've put foam insulation around the where this tube goes in. So Rockwood encloses the tanks on all their mini lights. So that does a couple things. One, the main thing it does is it protects the tanks from any road damage, like any rocks that are kicked up towards them. They could potentially crack them, puncture a hole, whatever the case is. But then the other thing that they do with the tanks, which is really nice, is that, again, they heat them. So they have heat strips on each of the tanks, both the gray, the fresh, and the black tanks, and that you can flip those on to prevent them from freezing on you too. They also happen to put heat tape by the, well, where these tubes end up connecting to the tanks as well. And then these little gate valves right here, you open and close to flush your system. So mate, are you feeling rather dirty? A little stinky?
I'm feeling dirty, Will.
Okay, well, here, this is for you then.
Oh, thanks.
This is your outside shower. So you have hot and cold water. And then the nice thing about RV showers is that once you get the temperature set, the last thing you wanna do is shut it off and to conserve water and then have to find the sweet spot again with temperature. So this little switch right here allows you to shut off the flow of water without having to adjust your hot and cold knobs. And then when you're ready, you can flip it back on again, but don't do what I just did and push it too hard, because that happens. So, also, there's a couple of things to talk about here. There's a light, of course, so if you want to shower at night, if you feel really filthy at night, you can do that. Or your kids, or your dog. Who knows? Maybe they just jump in the pond and you don't want to let them back in before you rinse them off. This right here is a black tank flush. Now, why is that important?
That is important because you do not want to take a hose into your camper, through the hallway, into the bathroom, open up the toilet, put a wand on there, mm-hmm. and then spray out the tank. That sounds like a lot of mess. This is way more convenient. It has sprayers built inside the tank, and it cleans it all out for you.
Now, right beside the outside shower is your cable and satellite connection. So there's two different ports here. This one right here is obviously for your cable. So at campsites that have, you know, cable hookup, you can just put the coax cable right to here. Now, if you have a portable satellite system, you can also hook up to this port here, and that will feed the satellite signal into the coach. This is where you connect your power at. And the nice thing about these new Furion plugs is that when you connect your cord to here, and as long as it's getting power, this little piece of plastic like here, right here, will actually light up for you. So if you're plugged in to your camper and you're plugged into your power and that light's not on, now you know I'm not getting power from either, you know, your generator, your pedestal to the coach. And so you can kind of figure out what's going on there. All right, guys, so now this is the driver's side slide, and there's not a lot of features here, but I did want to show you one very important thing. If you look inside the storage compartment, you'll notice here that this is not wood. So the way they framed out the inside of this is all aluminum. So Rockwood, the entire wall frame and the roof trusses, they're all aluminum and they're double welded. So each joint has two welds on it versus just one. And that's important because one, it offers a lighter weight construction and a stronger construction. A lot of guys are still using cheap one by one to frame out their furniture, and they're using cheap wood to do the walls, but Rockwood goes above and beyond, and that aluminum isn't gonna rot out on you either. So it's an important construction feature that Rockwood has, and it's something that's gonna add to the longevity of the coach.
All right, come on in and check out, this is the Rockwood 2304DS Ultralight. As you can see, being that it's a 25-foot camper and have this much room, this is unheard of. I can't even touch both ends of the coach with my hands completely out.
Yeah, there's a lot of features in this small of a space. I mean, one of which is this couch, right?
Yeah.
I mean, right here I have a little table that I can put in place and remove. Mate, you wanna show them how this reclines?
Ooh, is this a recliner one?
This is.
It is, look at that.
Yeah, so it's very unusual to have a couch that allows space underneath and recliners as well. Usually the reclining mechanism takes up too much of the space to have storage.
Yeah, I like the little table right beside you.
Right, and you can take these, put them together, use them for a little TV tray if you wanted mm-hmm. to, which, let's be honest, this is a pretty great setup because you're facing directly toward the TV.
Here's the other table too, guys. There is a table on both sides mm-hmm. if you're, you know, there is one for both.
Now, the one thing I'm all sure you're wondering is the bed, right? How does the Murphy bed work? So,
and how hard is it?
Yeah. So here, first take a peek at this because they have a nice strap here to help you lift up the couch and also help you get access to the storage underneath as well. Mm-hmm. You can fold this down. You could use this couch for sleeping, but why would you when you can just bring down the Murphy bed? So this is a short queen bed. It's 60 by 74 inches. So that way it can fold up into the wall. And if you look over there, you notice that there's the curtains on the window. So there's it's a two-stage curtain system. So that one is what they call the night shade. And that one is your day shade. And then you got your window.
Yep. You also have some nice power outlets on both sides. So you have mm-hmm. 110 outlet over there and then 110 outlet over here, but you also have a 12 volt outlet and a USB port over here. And if that wasn't enough, you also have another 110 outlet right here.
And one on this side too. So there's outlets all over the place on this. You know, mate, one of the things that I really like about the size of these nightstands is that I've had a few customers come in that need CPAP machines or something like that. You know, and that gives you enough space to actually put a machine like that on there.
Well, and then these are still tall enough to hang your shirt or whatever. Actually,
You know why these are drawers made is or shelves
right.
is because this one has a really great wardrobe space right over here.
That's right.
So we'll show you that in a sec. But I also want to point out one last thing before you fold that up is that these straps actually serve a really important function. And that is you don't have to remake your bed and take it apart every time you want to fold up or fold down your bed. You simply put these straps in place, they hold your pillows into position. And mate also used a release button right here. So this bed is gonna stay in position unless you pull that release button. And the reason for that is, let's say you like to read in your bed, right? So you decide to scoot back towards the window and let's say there's not a lock on the bed. What's gonna happen? You're gonna go right up with the bed and
be folded up. We've actually seen that happen.
We have.
On the early editions of, was it a Wildwood or a Rockwood?
I think it was a Rockwood, and it was before the days when they thought of the lock. So
yes.
Nowadays they have a lock, so you can go to the back of your bed, read in peace, and you don't have to worry about being folded up
with
it.
You know what the other thing I remember, Will, is the last time you and I did a Murphy bed, this whole thing was not a nice knob like it is nice and
no,
thin.
it was a strap like this, and we were live in Indiana doing a live broadcast, and I just ripped the whole thing off right in front of the RV rep. So
yeah,
that was great. Yeah.
Hey, by the way, we are going back out to Indiana here mm-hmm. very quick in the next month, so stay tuned. Make sure you subscribe because we'll have all of our videos from the Indiana show too. That shows you all the cool new features.
Yeah. Okay, guys. Now we want to show you how this dinette works, but before we break it all down, let's go over some of the features you're going to see here. So one of the things I want to point out is the window space in this slide out. It's come to think of it, just the window space in the entire Rockwood floor plan here. There's a window right behind our camera
Two, three
behind the bed.
Four, five, six, seven, eight. Did you count that one?
Nine
for the door. Windows.
That is unheard of in a camper this size. Most manufacturers won't put windows here or here, and they won't put windows on the sides of the slide out, but
Rockwood
does.
And they won't do a window on the very front either.
That's true, or on the very front. You couple that with your...
Oh, wait, you missed the window, Will.
Oh, I did, didn't I?
You have a skylight. Does that count as a window?
Yeah, I think so. And the vent up here.
Yeah.
So you open all that up, you turn on your high capacity fan in the bathroom, and then this whole thing will vent out really well.
Yeah.
Now, obviously this is a U-shaped dinette, right? And it has storage underneath. This right here, you can again see that aluminum framework construction that Rockwood does. So this one is really good for some longer items because you got a drawer on that side.
That's a good size pots and pans drawer even.
It is.
All right, shall we show how the bed or this folds out? So there's a little collapsible thing right here. So you do that, and then this whole thing
folds down, and there's these little, there you go.
And
then the whole table rests on. Yeah, you remove the top or the back two cushions. And then if you're long, if you're really tall, you can remove these as well. And there you go.
Wow, I'm not even.
Really,
wow.
If you need to, you can sleep two people on this. It's just a little bit narrow, but it's obviously long enough.
Yeah, I can even do the hand over head motion.
Well, yeah, and you're just about
5'11".
Yeah,
and 3/4".
And 3/4". reaching. Also, real quick to mention is that there's storage up here as well.
And a safety emergency window right here. So this window you can open up to get a lot of air movement through, or you can escape in a hurry if you need to. These are super nice too. The pleated shades, I like.
Rattle.
Yeah, so when I'm going back and forth like that, you don't hear all this ka-chinking noise because of all nine windows or eight windows, whatever it is, making noise. That is super annoying after about 5 seconds in a camper.
Yeah. Now, right by mate is that wardrobe we were talking about. So right here is a really, really big wardrobe for something this size. So you could use this for hanging clothes.
And then you have a pantry over here. And then if that still wasn't enough, you also have all this in pantry.
And so it's nice because you can use the two storage compartments we showed you by the bed that are shelves. You can use that for folded clothes, or you could use that for additional pantry space depending on whatever your needs are going to be.
Mm-hmm.
TV is here again, and it has a Furion soundbar, which is really nice, right underneath the TV. And then you may be wondering, well, how do I play movies and all that? That is all done from right here. So this has Bluetooth. This is your DVD player. This is your radio. You can plug in a USB to this or for charging. You can plug in an HDMI port. So you can plug in an HDMI system. I don't know. Let's say you're a gamer and you want to bring your Xbox or your Wii or whatever. Switch.
Switch, yes.
Switch. You can do that from here as well.
I also wanted to show you that this hookup right here is the same hookup that's on the outside. And it's cool that they didn't put it on the TV side, but all the way back here. That way you can even have the swing arm outside if you wanted to be able to get a better view outside.
Mm-hmm. And then this right here is for your omnidirectional antenna. So this will receive HD TV stations, and you can rotate it like this in order to kind of dial in the signal. Gone are the days of cranking your antenna up and cranking it down. This is a little bit shorter, so it's not gonna snag. Those older TV antennas, they were really, really high, and so we have people all the time who accidentally left them up and then a tree branch took them out.
I always like to make sure I point out, even this video is getting long, but I want to at least point out things that Rockwood does that almost nobody else does in their price point. One of the things is a lot of people might do a box AC, they might even do a ducted AC, but they don't do a ducted AC with double ducting all the way through. So as you can see, all the way through, this is gonna cool down your unit a lot more evenly. And notice how I can spin this and shut it. That's super nice because if you want all the cold air right by the couch or right by the dinette or right on you on the bed, you can do that without having to waste a lot of cold air that's super precious when it's 102 outside.
Now, also some of the things that Rockwood does that other people don't, right, is again, we talked about the subfloor being marine grade treated plywood.
Yes.
You have actual solid surface countertops as well.
Yes.
A lot of guys are still using T-molded countertops, which is just like a cheap formica and with a little insert stuck in on the edge.
Right. And once that comes out, it's never quite
The same.
And this actually has a lot of counter space for a 25-foot coach. Mm-hmm. Try to find one with this much counter space and this much floor space. You won't find it.
Right. Also, they do give you the larger oven, the 21 cubic inch oven versus the,
17.
Yeah, 17.
And then also, check out the size of these drawers here. If that wasn't a big enough pots and pans drawer,
these are
humongous. This is cool too. This is that filtration system that I was telling you about. So they throw in the filter. They also throw in a spatula with a bottle opener at the end. And they also put in your hardware for your towel rack and your toilet paper in here. The reason for that is because sometimes you might have a preference where you want those put. So we can either put them on or you can put them on once you kind of get used to your camper.
And it's nice to have the window right by the kitchen so you can get some breeze and also see out at your campsite as well. And you can pop that open and leave it open during the rain since it folds out from the bottom.
Yeah, because that's maybe where your fire is at or something like that, and you want to be able to see, is everything going okay?
You also have a larger microwave in this one too, don't you?
Yeah, 1.3 cubic foot microwave. So this is a little bit bigger than what you'll see as far as RV microwaves go. The other cool thing is they have this all flush. So you'll notice the sink is flush, over here is flush, which again just maximizes the amount of counter space. You also have this knife rack back here. So this is all slotted back there. And then this folds up to make as a doubles as a backsplash. And this is actually kind of important. So what this is a sheet to tell you how to run your TV. In fact, I was just talking to a customer right before we started this video.
Right.
Actually, Aqua's, because he's gonna try to go help him out. And they're like, we can't figure out our TV, we can't figure out our stereo or whatever. And this is the simplified instructions on how to do everything. You can leave it in your camper, and that way, 6 months down the road, you don't have to try to re-remember how to make everything work.
Right, right. The sink is also stainless steel, which is pretty handy. And Now this is, may not seem like a big deal, but I geek out over these little details like the cutting board here. So normally it's just like a one solid piece, but at least now they give it to you in two sections, because this is a built-in drying rack, which normally you don't have, but they just went ahead and did it for the Rockwoods. And you could use this one here, of course, as an additional cutting board if you wanted to as well. Even has a little rim around the edge to catch liquid that you're cutting into. Or not liquid that you're cutting into. When you're cutting into something and it exudes liquid. And there's your stainless steel, and in addition your high-rise faucet.
Pull-down sink faucet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, with an extension. And there's also outlets here as well, in case you needed to plug in something too. And here's your thermostat control. And again, there is more storage. Always more storage.
And then right behind you is, I wanted to point out, this is a gas electric refrigerator. The cool thing about this particular refrigerator, one, it's all electric. Two, it has these nice shelves in here, so it can get the airflow that it needs to keep the air circulating, but it's not just the metal shelves that sometimes people don't like as much. So it kind of gives you the accomplishment of both things. And separate freezer, which is super nice if you want it, because a lot of times freezer space kind of is important. So what they'll do a lot of times in a coach's size is give you just this size of a fridge. And so again, this is going to actually last you long enough to keep going.
All right, guys, now there's one last room to talk about, and that's the restroom. So come on in here, we'll show you everything. So, of course, you have lights. We forgot to mention that all the lights in the coach are LED as well. So that's a huge benefit to you, because it's brighter, it's cooler than the older style incandescent bulbs, and they take a tenth of the energy that the old bulbs did. Now, directly above me is also your high capacity fan. Now, this fan will move 920 cubic feet of air per minute when it's on the highest setting. And that is, there's four different settings. So this right now is the lowest. 2, 3, 4. And I know it's kind of hard to hear and feel right now, but I can tell you the air is circulating really quickly. And another thing that you is really hard to see, but if you notice, you can look through the fan and there's no sky. You don't see any sky. And that's because there is a cover over this whole fan assembly. So if you wanted to leave this open while you were driving down the road to help get a little ventilation in the coach, you can do that. It also prevents water from getting in too if it starts raining on you all of a sudden. Now, behind me is some linen cabinet storage. Again, more storage. Obviously you have your commode with a foot flush. So some people don't know how to work an RV toilet. You kind of hold down this foot flush halfway. It'll fill the bowl with water, and then when you're ready to flush, you push it down all the way and it just drops right into your tank. Take a look at the size of this sink, you guys. This is a really large sink for a camper this size. You also have a GFCI outlet right here as well. So if you really need to pack your hairdryer with you, I'm not judging, I'm just saying if you need to, then you can. There's also, again, more storage down here and medicine cabinet storage. Oh, yes! And,
That's cool.
Yeah, this is cool. This sticker right here says, smell that? Of course you don't. It's the 360 siphon. I am not paid by them. I wish I was, but yeah, what that does is, as long as there's even a little bit of a breeze outside, doesn't matter, a little bit of air moving, what that does is that pulls all the odor out of your tank, specifically your black tank, and pulls it up and out of the roof of the coach. Versus, you know, if your black tank's getting a little full, this seal here does a really good job of keeping all the smells down in there, but occasionally you might catch a little whiff, and that keeps that to a minimum. And then right behind me, two things. So this is your outside grill that comes with the coach. And then here's your shower. So obviously you have a skylight. For me, it's not a big deal, but if you're taller, you know, this will give you the room you need to get showered. It's a radius shower, which gives you plenty of room to turn around. Same style of shower head that we have on the outside shower. And then this is also important to note. If you look down here, that little black vent is for your heater. Another thing that Rockwood does that some guys do not is they heat the bathroom for you. So a lot of times there'll be vents out here to heat the main area, and then this is like the frozen throne room. So you can imagine showering where there's no heat at all. It's rather unpleasant. And that is the restroom. Oh, you can lock your significant other in here too, like this if you want. But it's really designed, of course, to keep it from flying open while you're driving down the road. Well, guys, that's the tour of the 2304DS.
Yeah,
thanks for watching.
Yeah, thanks for watching. If you liked the video, please hit the like button. Also, again, I'll remind you one last time, plug for us is the subscribe button, because you will check out all the coolest, latest stuff that's coming out. We've gotten some hints about it, and we will show them to you as soon as we see them. All right, thanks for checking out the ROCKWOOD 2304DS Ultralight with us.
You guys, we really actually do enjoy doing these videos for you. They're pretty fun. We hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have questions for us, you can always give us a call. We're in Colorado, so we're mountain time, and we're here 9 to 5, Monday through Friday, 9 to 6 on Saturdays.
Other way around, but yeah.
Sorry, yes, other way around. 9 to 6, Monday through Friday, 9 to 5 Saturdays. Our phone number is 970-313-4337. And you can always reach us by email too at sales@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com.
And one last plug to hit that subscribe button, because we are, in fact, if you look at that Rockwood right down there, that is their new front cap. Congratulations, you're the first to know about that. Not even everybody's walked through it yet. And so we're excited to see it ourselves and then check out all the new features. We'll be showing that to you, as well as a whole bunch of other new floor plans just in the near future.
Thank you guys for watching.